Hey guys, happy Sunday. I hope you had great weeks. Hope you're excited for songs with the one, the only, Mr. Levi.
Good morning, Fellowship Kids. It's me, Mr. Levi. I'm so excited to lead worship for you guys this beautiful Sunday morning. We're going to do two songs today, and the first song we're going to do is called Always. It's such an amazing song. Your parents know this song, too. We're not going to sing all of it, just part of it, because it's a pretty long song. But I thought this would be a great song for us to sing today. You guys ready? I'm sure you guys know it. Let's hear those beautiful voices. My foes are many, they rise against me, but I will hold my ground. I will not fear the war, I will not fear the storm, my help is on the way, my help is on the way. Amazing. Oh, I know the Lord loves hearing those beautiful voices singing. Guys, that song is awesome. We know that the Lord will not delay, and He's our refuge and our strength. Always, He protects us and takes care of us, and we don't need to be afraid because He is always there with us. Oh, so amazing. All right, guys, we're going to do another song. This one is called Zacchaeus. Some of you guys know this one. Put my pick down. Little guitar pick. We are going to do some hand motions with this song. It goes, Zacchaeus was a wee little man, wee little man, do a little wee man, and a wee little man was he. You can do this, the wee little man. He climbed up in a sycamore tree, do climbing motions, for the Lord he wanted to see. He's looking for Jesus. And as the Savior passed that way, you do a little Jesus walking down the road, he looked up in the tree and he said, Zacchaeus, you come down, talking up to this Zacchaeus, for I'm going to your house today. Do a little house symbol. This song is amazing, y'all. We'll talk about it at the end, but I want to see all of those hand motions and all those beautiful voices. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up. To see, and as the Savior passed that way, he looked up in the tree and he said, Zacchaeus, you come down, for I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today. Let's do that again, guys. That's so good. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up in a sycamore tree for the Lord he wanted to see. And as the Savior passed that way, he looked up in the tree and he said, Zacchaeus, you come down, for I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today. Guys, that was amazing. Oh, I used to sing that song when I was y'all's age. I bet your parents did too. Guys, that song is amazing because Zacchaeus, we know, he wasn't a really nice guy. He took money from people when he shouldn't have. And Jesus went to his house and spent time with him, even though Zacchaeus wasn't a very nice guy. And because Jesus loved him so much and wanted to spend time with him, Zacchaeus turned away from his old terrible ways and gave all the money back and dedicated his life to Jesus. How amazing is that? Guys, I hope that's some good encouragement for you, because there's nothing you can do to separate you from the love of God, and there's nothing anybody else can do to separate them from the love of God. God loves you, and if you trust in him, he will always be there for you. Guys, I love you. Keep washing those hands, and I will see you guys real, real soon. Be safe, y'all. Bye.
God had allowed the Babylonians to take over Judah. Now God's people were living in Babylon as slaves. Ezekiel the prophet had been taken with God's people to Babylon. Even in captivity, God gave Ezekiel visions so he could tell God's people about the future. One day, God gave Ezekiel a vision. God led Ezekiel through a valley filled with old, dry bones. God asked Ezekiel, "Can these bones come to life?" Ezekiel replied, "Lord God, only you know the answer to that question." God said, "Speak to these bones for me. Say, this is what God says. I will put breath in you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am God." Ezekiel spoke to the bones. Suddenly there was a noise, a rattling sound. The bones were coming together, bones to bones, tendons to bones, flesh over bones, and skin over flesh. But there was no breath in the bones. God said, "Speak to the breath for me. Say, this is what God says. Breath, come into these bones so that they may live." Ezekiel did what God said, and the breath entered the bones. They came to life, and a vast army stood before Ezekiel. God said to Ezekiel, "These bones are like my people of Israel. I want you to speak to them for me." God told Ezekiel to say, "This is what God says. I'm going to bring my people back to the land of Israel. I will put my spirit in you, and you will live." Then another message came to Ezekiel. God told Ezekiel to hold two sticks together in one hand so they would become one single stick. The first stick represented the kingdom of Judah, and the second stick represented the kingdom of Israel. God explained that his people would be one nation. They would have a new king to rule over them and guide them. God said, "My people will live forever in the land I gave to their ancestors." God would make a covenant of peace with his people forever. "I will be with them," God said. "I will be their God and they will be my people. Then everyone will know that I am the Lord." Apart from Jesus, we are like the dry bones Ezekiel saw. God showed Ezekiel his power to make dead people alive. We see God's power at the cross. Jesus died to save sinners. God raised Jesus from the dead, and he gives us eternal life.
Guys, I hope you liked the lesson. I know that it's kind of a different lesson. We don't often talk about bones and skeletons, and we think of those being scary or spooky or dark. But in this story, in this situation, God used something that normally we would see as dark to bring hope and joy to people who couldn't find hope. Their situation looked really sad. Their situation looked really frightening, that they may never be free again. They may never find hope. But God showed Ezekiel that he could take even something that looked hopeless and lifeless, like dry bones, and he could raise them to help provide a way for his will. So that gives us the encouragement to always trust God, no matter how dark or scary or overwhelming a situation may seem, that he will always use a situation to bring about his will, and we should always trust him and love him and believe in him. Guys, I miss you. Hope you're enjoying your summer, and I can't wait to see you soon. Have a great week.